Welcome to a time of Celtic worship. Come and sit on holy ground and pray with us from the center of your heart, soul, mind, and body. Draw closer to God through simple and everyday words and symbols. We will be exploring some of Jesus' walk to Jerusalem. So come and journey with others who are seeking a closer connection with the holy through the lens of the Celtic tradition. Worship with all the senses and with an openness of mind, heart, body, and soul. Welcome. O God, who called all life into being, the earth, sea, and sky are yours. Your presence is all around us, and every atom is full of your energy. Your spirit enlivens all who walk the earth. With her, we yearn for justice to be done, for creation to be free from threat, for the hungry to be fed, for captives to be released, for your kingdom of peace to come on earth. Let us pray. O God, gladly we live and move and have our being in you, yet always in the midst of creation's glory. We see sin's shadow and we feel death's darkness. It is around us in the earth, sea, and sky, in the abuse of matter. It is beside us, in the broken, the hungry, and the poor, in the betrayal of one another, and often, deep within us, in a striving against your spirit. O Trinity of love, forgive us, that we may forgive each other. Heal us, that we may become people of healing, and renew us, that we may be makers of peace. Amen. I invite you into our first of three times of meditation. Each one will be 3 minutes in length, and it's a time to think, meditate, and ponder the holy. What is God saying to you this day? saying sorry. God, you know us. You know that we can be loving and kind. And you know that sometimes we can get things wrong. We're sorry for the times we hurt other people. We're sorry for the times we forgot to listen to you and the times we didn't bother to take care of your world. May God forgive you, Jesus bless you, and God's Spirit help you to grow in love. Amen. Prayer of Commitment. Let us pray. God of new beginnings, you long for us to live in love and justice with our neighbors, with friends and strangers, with people everywhere. You call us to be just and loving in our working, in our shopping, in our caring, and through our prayers. Jesus, you were a storyteller. You talked about money, wages, and taxes. You told stories about integrity and forgiveness. You helped people who were in trouble. You listened to people who were sad. You call us to live as you did, to listen to each other, to be forgiving, and to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. Holy Spirit, we are discovering what you ask of us. You are wild and wise, and you speak the truth. You challenge and comfort us. You breathe life into us. You shout in the streets, and you whisper in our ears. You remind us what Jesus taught and practiced. You take us to task. You tell us to turn around. You call us to walk in love's way. Holy Trinity, God's love and community, every day and all our living, help us to say yes to you. Amen. I invite you into our second time of meditation. 3 minutes to think, meditate, and ponder the holy. What is God saying to you this day?
Thank you.
we will listen to a holy reading. Today we're using 2 minutes with God, 1 minute to listen, 1 minute to pray, by Leslie Brandt. When life has meaning. In the 15th chapter of John, it says, "You did not choose me, but I chose you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last." He who has a why to live can bear almost any how, said an old philosopher. Do not work for food that spoils, but for food that endures to eternal life, said Jesus. It is in the love and grace of God that empty souls find filling, guilty hearts find forgiveness, purposeless lives find a goal and design. You need to acknowledge that you are a person of worth. Such significance is not due to something acquired or merited through personal effort. I chose you and appointed you, said Jesus. It began with caution creation, when the human being was made in the spiritual image of God. That image was abused and distorted by sin and self-centeredness. The Christian is restored to God and God's purposes by means of the cross and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. You have been set free from sin's guilt and are now the recipient of God's saving grace. Thus, you can no longer live for yourself. It would only lead to your own blind alley and down dead-end streets. You're not your own. You were bought at a price, wrote Paul. Whether your work week is utilized in typing letters, collecting garbage, presiding over some corporation, caring for children, genuine meaning for life is realized when you are dedicated to following Christ. You can carry out God's purposes no matter what the arena in which he leads you. The prayer for the day. Dear Lord, it's difficult to believe that you chose me to be your child and servant on this world in which I have been born. I do not have within me everything it takes to meet the challenges of life about me, or to make any worthwhile contributions to my world or any of its inhabitants. While some of my youthful aspirations were generous and grandiose, they were often fanciful and unrealistic as well. They nevertheless did focus on one thing or another, and you graciously nurtured and shaped them into less selfish objectives. Eternal God, I need again and again to be returned to your will for my life. Forgive me for cluttering it up with self-centered ambitions. Restore me to your orbit and design for me. May the sense of divine purpose and goal keep me steady within and motivate me despite the confusions and consternations I meet along the journey of faith. Amen. For stories, for words that tell stories, for words that make us laugh and cry, for words that make us think, we thank you, God. We will have 3 minutes to ponder the reading. We have 3 minutes to think, meditate, and ponder the holy. What is God saying to you this day? Let us affirm our faith. We believe that God is present in the darkness before dawn, in the waiting and uncertainty, where fear and courage join hands, conflict and caring link arms, and the sun rises over barbed wire. We believe in a with us God, who sits down in the midst of our humanity. We affirm a faith that takes us beyond the safe place, into action, into vulnerability, and into the streets. We commit ourselves to work for change and put ourselves on the line to bear responsibility, take risks, live powerfully, and face humiliation. To stand with those on the edge, to choose life, and to be used by the Spirit for God's new community of hope. Amen. I offer this concluding prayer. Creator of all, Savior of all, Spirit in all, one God in complete community, stay with us now. Where there is apathy, kindle the flame of your love. Where there is deceit, confront every lie with your truth. Where there is hopelessness, reveal deep wells of compassion. Where there is joy, let your kindly protection be known. Where we hesitate to serve you, make us restless until we change. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And I offer this blessing to you. The light of God to lead us, the power of God to hold us, the joy of God to heal us, the grace of God to caress us, the love of God to bless us. May God, our Maker, bless us and wrap us round in love and tenderness. May Jesus, our brother, bless us and ask us questions that lead us to do justice. May the Holy Spirit bless us and fill our lives with her courage and wisdom. May we live bravely in the love of the Trinity all our nights and days. Amen. Thank you for being with me for this time of Celtic worship. I enjoy doing this with you together. We also have worship on Sunday morning at 9:30. You're always welcome to join us and be back again next Wednesday evening. Have a fabulous week, blessed week. Amen.